In those days, because there was no computers, there were, it was hard effects. You had to practically had to do it in a camera. There was a few optical houses, but things were limited. And you had to convince the audience a man could fly.
At one point, somebody dropped a clapperboard on the wire and cut off the electric current, and we quickly went, whoosh, and were hanging upside down, held in only by our safety belts. And Christopher actually did this. He reached out in character and held the pole as if he was going to hold us both up from gravity. And afterwards, I went, Chris, do you know what you did? And he went, oh, yeah. And I said, I think you're just a little too much in character. This is going too far.
I love that story.
The production presented countless logistical challenges. Locations stretched from the soundstages of London to farmlands in rural Canada to evoke Superman's three separate worlds of Krypton, Smallville, and Metropolis. The film is very much a three-act play. On Krypton, everything was shot through fog, and people spoke in almost Shakespearean language, and I wrote everybody the same way.
My friends, you know me to be neither rash nor impulsive. I'm not given wild, unsupported statements. And I tell you that we must evacuate this planet immediately.
When we go to young Clark growing up, it becomes like Andrew Wyeth. Colors and everybody's pa and ma.
And there's one thing I do know, son, and that is you are here for a reason.
And then all of a sudden, bang, you hit Metropolis and the jokes start flying.
Clark can't be seen like just a mild-mannered reporter, but listen, not only does he know how to treat his editor-in-chief with the proper respect, not only does he have a snappy, punchy prose style, but he is, in my 40 years in this business, the fastest typist I've ever seen.
You could tell in the first hour it was going to be one of the most pleasurable experiences that as an actor I hadn't gone through. I was surprised to hear Chris hadn't all that much acting experience, because he was so professional. Also, unlike a lot of actors, he was so well-mannered.
Not at all. I'd say it's been swell.
Swell? Yeah. You know, Clark,
yes.
There are very few people left in the world who feel comfortable saying it.
What?
Swell.
Oh, it sounds kind of natural.
Chris was very specific about Clark never behaving like Superman.
I don't know, I just think maybe better. Hmm?
Lois, what are you doing?
Clark's shoulders are held differently and his walk is different. And then there's this wonderful, confident, upright being that Superman has, and he strides in a certain way.
Good evening, Miss Lane.
Hi.
Chris was a very earnest young man, and he did very much feel obligated to the myth, to the movie. He worked really, really, really hard.
Is it true that you can see through anything?
Yes, I can, pretty much.
And that you're totally impervious to pain?
Well, so far.
What kind of underwear am I wearing?
Pink.
Do you like pink?
I like pink very much, Lois.
But as the production dragged on, the mood on the set was far from relaxed. The movie's special effects and flying scenes had pushed the film far over schedule and over budget. Tensions rose between Richard Donner and the Salkinds, and by the end of production, they were barely speaking.
The tension started to escalate because, of course, the budget was going completely out of control. It was everybody's fault and nobody.
Artists.
Because there were so many things that were new that had never been done.
After shooting more than 70% of the movie's intended sequel, the decision was made to focus entirely on finishing the first film and hope for the best.